Today's focus is on something I call the Tesla 2 million mile nightmare from the semi-truck and its impact on Cummins and Daimler-Benz and other competitors. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Thanks once again for joining us. If you're new to our channel, please take time to like and subscribe. If you're a returning guest, thanks for coming back to join us again. So one of the sort of ongoing processes of figuring out Tesla and Elon Musk is a whole idea that once he does a presentation, he will often present a whole bunch of ideas and new things that Tesla's doing. And it's left to us and other journalists to kind of figure out, what is he thinking? Does it make sense? Can he do it? And what are the implications of that? So in terms of what he presented, he seemed to be most excited with how fast a truck can go. The problem is that there aren't a lot of trucks that are involved in racing, so that's a form factor that really is a huge impactor on the lives of most people who are having to drive and deal with trucks. And what I decided to look at today is the whole area associated with that Elon Musk offered. Now, there's a whole bunch of things that go with that $1 million or 1 million mile service guarantee. And I'm fascinated by how that plays out. So if you think about it, the form factors that make the difference for people, everything's about cost in most industries in terms of profitability. When you look at what Elon has proposed, he's proposing ideas that represent a heavy cost impact on the industry. So the biggest sort of initial idea is that when you use an electric vehicle, it's 90% efficient, versus if you use a diesel engine or ICE engine, it's 30% efficient. So it means that when it's 30% efficient, all the rest of that fuel ends up being smoke in the air that does nothing. In the case of electric, obviously the 90% efficiency works well. What the core idea here is that when you use electric, you get 3 times the fuel economy and without destroying the environment. Now, this is sort of the main sauce that drives interest in what trucks and electric is really should be all about. Well, Elon introduced what I think is a game changer, and I was trying to figure out why there were so many brilliant corporations around the world that were focused on acquiring this truck and in large numbers. And as you may recall, and I'll put a link to it, we did a brief look at the cost differential that Elon put up, you know, one truck to the other, and we determined that it was in general about a 10% reduction in cost. So I kept wondering to myself why the best corporations are so jazzed about a 10% savings. And yeah, it's nice to do the PR stuff, et cetera, et cetera. But then I arrived at something this weekend that I was really shocked by. And what that is that if you look at the data, most trucks in the United States that are Class 8 go about 100,000 miles a year, and they get replaced every 4 or 5 years. So what basically is happening is that you go on a 5-year cycle of a bunch of people buying, and then there's light buying, and then there's another 5-year buy. Well, if Tesla all of a sudden introduces a truck that goes 1 million miles before it needs maintenance, this is a nightmare. And the nightmare shows up in a bunch of different ways. Number one, there's a bunch of repair work that's not going to be done, right? So there's a bunch of people, parts, all these other things that aren't needed. Another nightmare aspect is, look at what he did with the glass on the vehicle. By installing the type of glass that's shatterproof, unless you have a nuclear bomb go through it, that's a lot of 1 or 2 windshields a year that are not going to be replaced, and it also means you have less downtime for your truck. The biggest nightmare, and I haven't totally forgot the numbers yet, but let's throw out some general possibilities, is associated with this 1 million miles. Now, we'll see how much this costs Tesla. Can they pull it off? There's a whole bunch of questions. But because they're targeting that 1 million miles, clearly all those customers are looking at taking out the current repair cost that's not associated with routine things like tire changes, et cetera. Well, the other problem that pops up is if you have one truck that goes a million miles and the other truck goes 500,000 miles before being replaced, what this means is that it takes two diesel or ICE engine trucks to equal one Tesla. So basically, if a truck is averaging, let's say, $125,000 in a diesel side, and you buy two of them, that's $250,000. Now, if Tesla charges $180,000 or $180,000 for their truck, you all of a sudden got a problem. And the problem is that you basically got a 50% discount off of an already low price on the Tesla because of the maintenance and because of how far this vehicle will go. Now, what I found interesting is that if you think about it, in theory, what Elon Musk is implying is that this is about a 2 million mile truck. The first million, there's no maintenance. So what if you did a little maintenance on that truck? Now that second million miles is being set up. So let's just play around with what that maintenance might be. Each of the motors weighs 70 pounds and they have 17 parts in them. And there are four of them in the main configuration that he's going to use. Now, in theory, you can overhaul that entire truck in about an hour with a couple of mechanics because you simply go in and unhook the motors, put a new one in, and do that four times. And I think it's 15, 20 minutes or so per. So while the truck is just charging, you could, in theory, do what's called an overhaul. In the case of ICE or diesel engines, they have 2,000 parts to deal with, so overhauls don't happen in 1 hour. They're actually very expensive and time-consuming. So what's buzzing in my brain and why I wanted to make this is that if in fact the Tesla does last for 2 million miles, as we're predicting, what that means is that when you buy one Tesla truck, you in essence are saving buying four diesel or ICE vehicles. So I think that's pretty freaking mind-blowing, because basically you're spending, call it $180,000 for a Tesla, and instead of buying a truck every 5 years, you might buy a truck every 15 or 20 years. And that, I think, is revolutionary, because it allows people to not only cut their fuel consumption costs, not only cut their maintenance costs, but also, if you will, the CapEx or the cost of that vehicle as it's blended into the overall operating costs. So I just think that this is a colossal nightmare, because if you have Teslas sitting out there for 20 years and still having, you know, excellent service to the users of those products, when in fact they were supposed, a truck supposed to die after 5 years or be replaced, there's a whole bunch of entities that see buyers every 4 or 5 years that won't see them for 10, 15 years once Tesla gets into the game. I'm reminded, for those of you who are young enough, when, I don't know if you recall this, but probably 20 years ago, there was a situation happened where there's a transition that went on from American vehicles to a lot of people starting to drive, particularly Japanese Toyota and Hondas. And what had happened was there was a whole bunch of dealers, or one of the things I learned about, I flew to Detroit one day and I was hanging out with a good friend of mine at his parents' home. And he reviewed me with the fact that Detroit will actually build a car. And then in order to have more profits the next year, they will take that car and figure out if they can shave off bolts, etc. So that second year car would be more profitable than the first and they could see an upward trajectory in earnings. Now, this was a good idea for those guys, but the problem was it resulted in a lot of repair work. And the dealerships love the repair work because all of a sudden they could have a large amount of income that's coming off of repairing Detroit vehicles that would break down all the time. Well, all of a sudden the Japanese arrived and they were putting cars out that would stay on the road for double the length of time with less repair. Toyota and Honda still are getting high residual values now, 20 years later, because they still deliver amazingly high quality products. So what this resulted in is all of a sudden dealers used to making all that money and the repair side of the business were screwed. They were forced to take on the Toyotas and Hondas of the world, but they were hard pressed now to find the profits that were sitting in the repair side of the business when it was just a Detroit controlled environment. So consumers kind of got the wind of what had been going on and suddenly switched dramatically in terms of who's the leader in the United States in terms of sales. And you saw a decline in the sales of GM and Ford, et cetera, that was associated with this shift. Now let's sort of port this over to what's going on with Tesla. And you can see where the nightmare can show up, which is, I don't think the trucking companies are trying to make people spend a lot more in their repair work. But the problem is that the engines have a lot more parts and therefore need a lot more work to both maintain and keep them on the road. And in the case of Tesla's engines, there's just not a lot of parts there that need to be repaired, replaced. And this is a nightmare on the parts side of profitability for a lot of the dealerships, for all of the big companies, as this electric revolution drops in. There's a question that I don't have the answer to that I think is really fascinating, which is, we talked about Daimler-Benz and some of the back and forth with Tesla, but as I was really digging into this whole idea of the million mile guarantee, one question that popped in my mind was, what happened to Mercedes-Benz's million mile guarantee to their customers regarding service? Because they've now entered the electric market with a couple of different vehicles, 1.6 and 1.7 truck. And I've seen no place in the literature of Daimler related to this million mile guarantee. So this also brings up the question, how can a company, like I said, the size of Daimler, get outflanked by a small company like Tesla? And it may be part of the whole issue of the animosity that we've seen going on. So basically, what I'm suggesting in this period is just the idea that there's a concept called a depreciation schedule. So usually trucks are depreciated over 5 years and then you get rid of them and then the costs hit accordingly. What if you now have to depreciate a vehicle between 1 and 2 million miles? So I think a million miles is a no-brainer based on what Tesla has planned. The question is, at that million miles, do they do the overhaul for those engines I described and maybe a couple of other parts? And now it gets one more extra million miles. So your depreciation schedule for a Tesla ends up being, take 180 grand and spread it over over 20 years. And you get a number, and I'll just put a chart up for what that depreciation schedule might look like, and take an ICE vehicle, and the depreciation schedule is 5 years. So from just looking at the raw numbers, you basically need five ICE vehicles to equal what one Tesla is able to do. Now, I think this is mind-blowing, and hence why I decided to make this this video and look forward to what you guys had to say about this, but it explains some of the excitement as to why there are so many heavy users of ICE vehicle trucks that are buying a lot of Teslas, and it'll head into the future dramatically. And, you know, I'm still looking forward to hearing from Daimler-Benz and others regarding their million mile guarantee. Any rate, wanted to note that we're working hard to get the sound right and also working to change up the video images that you see. So any input on changes is always helpful. Please note we're hard at work to make sure we do a better job on sound, better job on video on a regular basis. Again, look forward to any all comments you might have. Tschüss, Max Gut, au revoir, Lahit Raot, Hoda Hafez, and have a great day.